Okay, so we have taken our octahedron, and I've used the how press tracing wheel and made those interior lines a little more visible, or very visible. And now I'm going to cut this out. And again, this is just Braille paper and copying, in this case, an octahedron onto plain Braille paper. And it was not raised. So I'm cutting the exterior or the perimeter out. And then I have, as I said, took a tracing wheel from How Press and made the perforations along all the interior lines. Okay, so now this is what it looks like this side. And if you turn it over, so now you can see my handiwork on this side where I've done all these perforations. So truthfully, in some ways, this is nicer for some of my students, because this folds, well, I hope it's gonna, let me see if I can do this right. It folds up maybe even a little nicer. In this case, we have a little bit different shape. And sometimes what I noticed was that my Scotch tape fits a little better, or sticks a little better on the Braille paper. Okay, and I'm gonna take this, try to do this relatively carefully, if I can get it there. I'll tell you, students are not all thumbs like I am, but I'll prove that it can be done. Even an old teacher can do it. So I'm folding this up. And need a little more Scotch tape, because remember, this is an octahedron, which means it has eight faces, which are all regular polygons, remember, and happen to be triangles. Again, it takes a little bit of patience and on my part, less klutziness. I am really klutzy. Okay. And there we have it. Now, it doesn't sit exactly as nicely as the tetrahedron, but hopefully you can tell that we have, if I put it kind of on its edge here, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and then on the bottom we have 1, 2, 3, 4, which makes 8. So we have our octahedron right along with our tetrahedron. Let me put those over there. There we go. Okay, so we've got an octahedron and a tetrahedron that our students have made, either with swell paper, where we copy onto this special kind of paper and run it through the machine that raises all the black lines, or we can put it on Braille paper as a teacher, go through and trace along all of the inside lines so the students can tactually fold on those, Scotch tape it up, and we have our three-dimensional objects made from two-dimensional nets. So I hope all of you can do that better than I can do it. Okay.